And I think in all of our lives, there comes a time when we can do things and when we need some help from people. You just need to look at your life right now. Like, is this a time where maybe you need that extra hand or you need to join that group for this? Like, I'm extending my hand to people to help them recover. How's it going, guys? Miguel here with CFS Recovery. I want to ask you a simple but very straightforward question. Are you ready to get better? You're probably looking at me and thinking, what does this guy mean? What do you mean, do I want to get better? Of course I want to get better. I've been wanting to get better for so long. Sometimes what we think we need is actually different from, you know, what's going on in here, the story we tell ourselves. There's a scale of readiness to change. On one end you have, let's say this is like a one, people who are not ready to change at all, and you know they're not going to recover, at least for now. And on the other side, there's a 10, and these people are ready to do literally whatever it takes to recover. They'll do everything they can. They want to recover. They wanted to do it for a while, and they're very clear. They'll do literally whatever it takes to get better. And so, within the scale, you know, there's a very wide range. But the thing is, a lot of it comes down to our subconscious thoughts as well. So for me, for the longest time, I really wanted to get better. I told myself that I wanted to do whatever it takes, but at the end of the day, when it came time to do the brain retraining, when it came time to do the meditation, when it came time to let go of all the thoughts I was currently having to try to renew myself into this new person, I wasn't able to let go of that. And I was still holding on to this idea of this person I was in the past, this athlete, this high achiever, this successful personal trainer, this person who had everything in his life going right for him, and this person who was willing to do whatever it takes to get what he wanted. And I didn't want to let go of that. So even though I wanted to recover and really get better, I wasn't able to let go of this person I was. Because the reality is, in order to really, really recover, you need to let go of a part of you. And there's a part of you that is actually needing to go away. And it's really scary because a part of you actually needs to die in order to move forward. And I'm not talking about you, I'm talking about the ego, the person we think we are, this thing up here that caused us to do all the things that we've done. And it's part of our identity. And that's the scariest part, is most people are not ready to let go of their identity, of who they were, of who they are. And they're not willing to let go of that to become this thing in the future, become this better version of themselves, because they don't realize how much better they're gonna feel once they let go of that. And they don't realize this whole different future they're missing out on by holding on to all these beliefs they have. And so I just wanna kind of paint a picture here. So for people who are at a one in terms of readiness to change, if they're, let's say, from one to three, you'll typically see people who are in denial, or they think they can just push through this, that's like a one. Or people who think it's just gonna go away over time. Usually this is where we're at in the early stages, and usually the worse and worse things get, the closer we move towards a 10 on that scale of readiness to change, because you know we just really don't have any other options. Now, in the middle of that scale, let's say from like a 3 to 6, 3 to 7, we're looking for treatments. We know there's something wrong, and we know we need to do something about it. So we go and try doing all these different things, but the thing is, we don't stick to something. We don't want the recovery as bad as we want to stick to something. And we're not able to be patient enough to actually recover. And you also still might have some doubts and thoughts and fears of letting go of who you are now in order for what might come to be in the future. Because you really do have to change the way you think and really your identity. Like, look at me, I was a personal trainer, super fit. I had to reinvent myself, so I couldn't go back to the fitness world. I went into a completely different industry with completely new people, and that was, you know, the video industry and video production. I started making videos for my friends and all of that. I was okay with not being that personal trainer anymore and not driving around in this nice sports car and not being the go-to guy that people look up to. I didn't even want that. I was like, please, I don't want any of this pressure anymore. I just want to be myself and do what I really want to do. And I was able to let go of that. What really made me a 10 was when I was in a position where I literally had no choice but to trust my doctor and follow what he says. And I got really lucky because he came in at the perfect, crucial time. And I think in all of our lives, there comes a time when we can do things and when we need some help from people. And you just need to look at your life right now. Like, is this a time where maybe you need that extra hand, or you need to join that group, or you need to get that help from that one person for this? Like, I'm extending my hand to people to help them recover. Some people are not ready for that. Some people are not ready to let go of their current identity. But for people who are ready to let go, and you know, who are just tired of doing this and living with pain and suffering, and most of all, they're ready to change, and they're ready to implement these things, they're ready to implement these habits to try to get better, and they're willing to stick to it, and they're tired of, you know, trying this treatment and that treatment, and they're tired of running in circles. If they're ready to change, those are the people specifically that I want to work with, because those are the people who are ready for the change. You know, let's rewind the clock. If I was 2 years into my illness and I met my doctor then, and he told me all the stuff that he told me when I was in the hospital, if he told me that 2 years earlier, I wouldn't have taken it to heart. I wouldn't have really believed everything he was saying, and I wouldn't think that I was bad enough that I needed to implement all this stuff. And it wasn't until I got really, really, really bad, until my back was against the wall and I exhausted all other options, that his message came to me at the right time. So that's why I make these videos, and a lot of them seem kind of repetitive, but I just never know who these videos are gonna reach at the right time. Maybe you've watched a video on this channel that really resonated with you and that really made you go, huh, you know, let me go try that. Let me implement that. That makes a lot of sense. And maybe there are other videos that you don't really resonate with, that aren't as powerful, but you'll find these things that reach you at the right time. And when you're ready for change, almost everything is gonna feel like it's helping you move closer to that direction, because you have this one ultimate goal of thriving health, and you're pretty much absorbing information like a sponge, and you're seeing all these signs, and you're interpreting all these different things as getting better every day. And that's when you start to look for proof that things are getting better. That's when you start to, you know, follow the game plan, follow the strategy, and really stick to it. And that's the biggest thing, is sticking to it. And I feel like once people reach that certain point, say they're at like a 10 out of 10, then it's a lot easier to recover, because they're all in, and they're gonna follow through no matter what. They're not just gonna dip their toes in something and try it and kind of stop doing it after a while. So that's the biggest thing, is you need to be willing to let go of who you are for who you will become. And it's a lot easier said than done, because literally a part of you dies, your ego dies, but you become this new person. You become, I was talking about, you become a thriver who becomes better because of an illness like this. So I would suggest just reevaluate where you are right now. See where you are on that scale. You don't have to be at a certain stage. You know, I'm not saying it's bad to, if you're at like a 5 or 6 or 7 and you're not ready for change, because some people are just not ready for change. For me, I truly wasn't ready for a few years, because I kept doing the same things over and over again. But when I was ready, I was fortunate enough to receive help at the right time when I needed it the most, and I was most ready for change. So just be aware and ask yourself if you're holding on to something from the past, or holding on to who you are, and you're afraid to let go of that, because a lot of times that's what stops people from moving forward. They're holding on to their beliefs of not just negative, but even positive things, like being the best at something or being a certain person in society. And you really have to reinvent yourself once you become better. You become a new person, but it's for the better. So if you haven't already, hit the link down below, join our community of thrivers on Facebook. Every once in a while, we have a live Q&A where it's very interactive, and I get to know you guys a little bit more. You guys get to know me a little bit more, and we kind of just, you know, have a chat. There's nothing really planned. We kind of just go by Q&A and let the conversation flow. Whatever you guys need help on, that's kind of what I provide in those sessions. It's completely free. And if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to this channel. If you're new, we have tons of videos. We put out 3 main big videos a week, and we're releasing 2 short snippets that are bite-sized, that you can take away and start applying. So I hope you guys have a great day. Keep at it, keep up with your recovery, and just try to become more aware of where you are at in terms of readiness to change. And once you are 100% ready to go, I'm here to help you. You can either book a call, or you can apply to be part of our Jumpstart Recovery Program, where we will hop on weekly calls. We'll be in a group setting, and there's gonna be 6 weeks strategically planned out, where we're gonna focus on things to help you get unstuck in your recovery. And I've put it together based on what helped me get better. And I went back and looked at what were the different things I was doing at different stages in my recovery? I pretty much put that all into an easy to understand kind of 6-week program. And that's something that's gonna be really powerful. That's gonna help a lot of people. So if you are interested in that and you're at a 10 out of 10, ready to change, and it's something you wanna do, just click the link down below where you can learn a little bit more. Then you can apply and see if you're a good fit for the program. We're not accepting everybody because we know not everybody is the perfect fit for this. So I'll see you guys in the next video.